Go ahead, no, insert, ready? Hold on, ready?
Let's go! Cause I'm feeling like I'm running and I'm feeling like I gotta get away. Better know that I don't and I won't ever stop. Cause you know I gotta win every day.
Go!
She didn't really wanna pop me. Boom. Just know that you will never flop me. Oh. And I know that I gotta be a little cocky.
No.
You ain't never gonna stop me. Every time I come, I gotta set it, then I gotta go and then I gotta get it, then I gotta blow it, and I gotta shut it. Any little thing and the thing that he be doing, cause it doesn't matter, cause I'm gonna did it.
Timetable
is. Fucking God.
First off, like,
so
legit.
Looking at the Dwarven Dice Vault promotion for June.
Ooh.
It is professionally translated. What kind of dwarven?
Token dwarvish.
Are you joining us for the?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. Should we look at them or do you want to tell me the concept?
The concept, we ran a similar one last year. It's the same thing, but it's new materials.
Oh, new materials.
Some new materials, some slots.
Let's start at the
more affordable option.
We've got two versions of this at the moment.
So these are both rock maple. This one, it looks like a copper.
Yep.
Is it a copper fill and then a basic engraving?
Yep.
Oh my gosh. Well, you guys go.
We want this available to as many people as possible. Doing a straight up engraving is going to have the lowest price point we can.
Yep.
So I'm gonna go maple engraving.
Maple engraving.
The next tier is kind of also an A or B choice.
Ooh. All right, so we've got, it's purple and blue. I have no idea. It's sugalite or lapis lazuli.
My thought was, malachite might really look good with the white
oak. Could. For me, the blue versus purple, I don't have a really strong opinion. These are both still potential. Cause I don't know.
So the next one's kind of one that, we've done it, we know it works, and it's, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
I know it's a classic, I know people like it.
Yeah, it looks good.
It's the bad guy dwarf.
Actually, the bad guy dwarf.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Oh, that's pretty cool.
Now we're talking. Yeah. Ooh.
That's
the Wengame turquoise.
And then last but not least.
This looks so good.
Ooh.
That looks so good.
Is that copper, bronze?
It looks like brass to me. Brass with Macassar ebony.
What's up, Bobby?
Oh, hey, Bobby, guys. Dude.
The current question is which of those is your favorite?
Yeah.
Don't think I love either of these colors.
Jason, you said malachite, right? That's green?
Yeah.
I could picture that looking good.
I think that would be really good on the white oak.
How long is it going to take you to make a malachite?
How fast can you get a malachite?
Actually, pretty quick.
Okay, so why don't you do that? We'll cut and then come back.
Cool.
Okay.
A few moments later.
All right, JV, before we hear from these non-artists, let's hear from an artist.
Wow.
Sorry, Bennett.
Wow.
Sugalite's my favorite.
Sugalite. I think I'm on team malachite. Ooh. I like green.
Ooh.
It's that easy. I like green. I like green. Last thing I want to ask, when's this thing launching?
I think today.
Oh, fuck. Are you kidding me?
JV.
This will probably air next Wednesday.
Okay, well, it'll be there.
It's live right now. Link in the description.
Hey, you know what?
Record.
Jason,
you're right.
Fix the mic.
Yeah. Just record Jason struggling for about 5 minutes.
I don't know how this got so locked up.
No. So yeah. Oh, you are. This is
Scott.
Scott. What's your last name?
Ismail.
Scott Ismail. Yeah. In beautiful. Where are we?
We are in Hampton, Maine.
And this man has made some really incredible pieces of furniture. We're here to check out. Although, am I overselling it?
I hope. Maybe.
Now, you're not a professional woodworker.
No.
You're an amateur woodworker.
Very much so.
I think hardcore amateur woodworkers are doing some of the best, if not the best, woodworking out there right now. Like, they have no, like, profit motive or incentive. It's just a fucking craft of love.
Mm.
We're here to do a wood shop tour, check out the furniture, and watch Jason struggle with fixing JV's audio equipment.
My mic is jammed.
This is gonna be like an episode of Cribs.
Disappointing episode.
Hi, Jason.
Kirsten. Hi, Ted. Nice to meet you.
We have donuts, so.
Yeah.
Oh.
We've been waiting for you.
We went all out.
Really? Yeah, oh, how do we eat donuts with masks on?
It's a very messy process, but I'm going to try. You just
I love the blue room back there.
Yeah.
So nice.
Now that's how you do a blue wall.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's more toned down than.
I approve of all the
Caicos turquoise
nonsense. Oh my god, no! This is so bad.
You know what? To see the workshop?
Let's do workshop first.
Prepare to be blown away.
I'm ready.
I'm going to show you what CNCs are all about down in this workshop.
Is this home built?
This is home built.
Nice. Whoa! Nice. What's your background? Are you like a mechanical engineer or?
Yeah. Okay. There's a company called Salsilva that basically sold you an instruction book and then what to buy from Home Depot to build it and put it together.
That's awesome.
I'm going to show you the mark of quality. Note the duct
the
tape.
The shim. Yeah.
The duct tape.
Can you fire this thing up?
Yeah.
I have never thought of listen to that. You hear it? Sign of quality.
This is old school.
I love it.
One day I'll have a real one, but I've been really happy.
Whoa. To me, this
why do you have to say that in front of the machine? You're gonna have a real one?
Do you have a tank painted on your wall? Like a full-size tiger tank?
CNC on the wall.
Whoa!
Is there a tool that might be able to...
Oh, yeah. Do you have, like, channel locks or something that we can try and... All right, Davey, how pissed are you going to be if I break your mic?
That is Wyrmwood's mic.
Oh, it's fine. I don't know. This is, like, locked the fuck up.
What have you done, JV?
I don't know.
What have you done? How expensive is this mic?
It's $300.
Audio quality on what we're recording right now, it better sound like a tin can.
Put it in my backpack.
Oh.
Hey. Now you're gonna hear it. Now you're gonna hear it.
Listen to that audio.
Oh, it's so much better.
Doug, you sound incredible.
I'm sure I do.
Everything we're gonna see upstairs
was
made downstairs, right down here.
Absolutely.
Are you open to licensing designs?
Yeah, that would be amazing to work with you guys on something, honestly. My wife will tell you. I followed you guys from the beginning. And I just,
oh, really?
Yeah. Have you? I think it's awesome. And I'll show you up there, but Prophecy is what inspired my table build.
Yeah, let's go see it. Let's go see it.
Whoa! You just lit it up.
Whoa.
What'd you do?
I'm magic. I touched it and it lit up.
Look at this. Those are magnetic rails. Oh. Magnetic rails.
Whoa.
Directly stolen
you
from.
You will be hearing from Frank.
Yeah, right.
Yes. I'm gonna give you the quick rundown. So you guys came out with Prophecy, and I said, God, that is a gorgeous table. Honestly, and I said, honey, I gotta build a game table. So I built this game table because I just wanted. Get a sense for what
you built this one.
Like.
So cute.
Yeah, I like how your table went up and down.
Yeah.
But I wanted this something for the dungeon master to have like a pre-built dungeon inside and lift the whole thing up. But this just looked kind of pregnant and weird.
Yeah. Does this go up and down?
I'll show you. You got this level.
Ooh.
Oh.
I'm just gonna lift it straight up.
What? Oh my gosh. Oh, the dungeon.
Another dungeon.
I love the dwarven architecture in the Lord of the Rings. I wanted a dwarven conference table. And I thought, what would the dwarves make it on? They make it on the broken column of, you know, one of their stone columns.
Oh, no one's got this side of it, though.
I'm picturing having, like dwarven forge stuff or something really cool.
So sure,
you have a level of a dungeon. Your party finds a stairwell on the way down.
What the hell?
Oh, my God. You pop that.
Oh!
This just keeps going.
It's like a parking garage.
Oh, yeah.
And I think that's the advantage of the central column.
Oh, my gosh, dude.
Never remember which side comes out first.
Okay. Three.
God, it gets
you
better.
You gotta
every
be
second.
Kidding me.
The engraving that you did on this, it's everywhere.
Lord. It's all on that little CNC machine.
Right, it has like ampersands, and on this side, there's like the JR Tolkien. Yeah. And like these little things,
the
this
detail.
Is all engraved.
So that's the extent of how far it goes down. The other concept is I wanted everyone to have the same view of the game surface, so I like that we're all kind of in a circle.
This is what I'm interested in.
Let's say something happens to the inside there. How easy or difficult is it for you to access that and fix things?
Well, I got the door down here, and it's got a little key on it. A dwarven key with some...
Oh my god, you're such a nerd!
That's on there.
Oh my god!
And then you get.
There he is.
Layer shelves underneath here. Look, they're framing more engravings. Oh, wow. You're a madman.
No, dude,
look at this. Look at this fucking hex chest ripoff right here.
Your dice tower is ripped off directly over there.
Oh, that's so cool. He did a really good job.
Really close.
He did a really good job. The full system? The complete system?
I told you I've been fancier.
Oh my god. You are like the best DM in the world.
Yeah.
Like, look what he's fucking doing for his party.
I've never DM'd before, so I probably suck.
What are you playing? 5e, Dungeons and Dragons?
Yeah. There we go, 5e.
Shut the fuck up.
Hey. You have no
fucking opinion. Hey, I'm team 5e.
You have no fucking opinion.
What I want to know is, how insecure does Jason feel after that?
Oh, yeah.
Calling me out like that. I could do that if I wanted to.
I mean, I left my business card with him, so, you know. We may have job openings.
Like you are. You're actively trying to get as many people to do my job as possible.
I can call ahead, too. And you guys can follow me right over there. So
that'd be great.
Yeah, I'm starving. Let's get some lunch.
This is the first time I am sitting in a restaurant in fucking three fucking months.
Yep.
Oh, God, it's been too long. Yeah.
And it is pretty empty right now. Pretty empty.
Like Bobby keeps talking about, like, when can we lose the mask? Because Bobby hates the mask, because you can't see people's face. You can't see the reactions.
Yeah. Yeah. This is the first time on Wyrm Lyfe in months. There's no masks. And Bobby's not here for it.
Hey, cheers to that.
Cheers to that.
Yeah. Two step with me, two step with me. Yeah. Two step with me, two step with me.